Well, celebrity impressionist Jim Meskimen became an internet sensation after posting this little old clip.
As I am a Christian faithful man, right, I would not spend another such night tormented by a world of happy days.
That is uncanny, and we're very happy to have the man of many voices with us in the studio today. Good morning to you, Jim.
Yeah, good morning, good morning.
It is great to have you here. Yeah. Your George W. Bush is incredible.
Thank you very much. And I do a lot of, I love to change personalities, and audiences love to see a guy suddenly change to someone else. You know, there's something marvelous about that, you know. I think we forget that you can shift viewpoints very quickly.
At first, when they announced that you were going to be the speaker for the keynote, I was a little unsure of what this had to do, you know, the relevance to IT. And then when you came through, and through the use of mannerisms and characters that I know or personalities and incorporated back to IT and some of the concepts that are universal to people, I started to get it. Plus, it was entertaining as well.
We're going to take a look at why and how you should develop and improve your skills at observation so that you can look at things in a new way. What do you do?
Programmer, mm-hmm. ITA.
Okay, and what is that? What do you do? What do you actually do?
Programming.
So, like, in your daily job, what sort of things are you programming? What kind of things are you trying to create or help or do?
I work on fire projects.
Fires. So, the fires.
Yeah, we support our fire department.
Okay, and what do you help them do? With the programs.
This.
I know you don't carry the hose. What would Emily's story sound like, I wonder, if it was narrated by Morgan Freeman?
This is the story of Emily. Emily worked very hard at a computer terminal all week long, doing a very, very holy and solemn thing called programming.
All right, what's going to happen is I'm going to spin the wheel like this. We're going to get a celebrity. You see that? And we've got Matthew McConaughey's first. I'm going to read the quote for the movie in Matthew McConaughey's voice, and then we're going to take turns. You got to guess who actually said that in what movie. Scott? Hamburgers, the cornerstone of any nutritious breakfast. All right. Courtney, you go first.
Who is that? I must say that Patrick Stewart is becoming fast my favorite because, well, wouldn't you rather act like Patrick Stewart than yourself most times? If you're a gentleman, I mean.
Get your coat and grab your hat. Leave your worries on the doorstep. Just direct your feet to the sunny side of the street.
Can you hear that pitter-pat? And that happy tune is your step. Life can be so sweet on the sunny side of the street.
My name is Russell Crowe, and I'm reading for Colonel Sanders. There comes a time in every man's life when he realizes he must make a sacrifice for his family. Go out and pick up some chicken.
It's finger-licking good, which may not sound sanitary, but I think it's descriptive of the terrific flavor of my chicken.
I'm Captain Sanders, and I say that... Is it Captain?
Colonel.
Sorry.
Colonel Sanders. Again.
Look, if you're looking for something good to eat, then have some chicken. I don't know what to tell you.
There are plenty around who admire your sound and the feeling of you that it brings. So, sing out and speak up. It's good reason enough. And if someone complains when you sing, keep on singing, keep talking. Just drown out their squawking. Let the world hear what you have to say. Don't agree to be quiet. It's a scam, so don't buy it. And I'll bet you'll like your voice as much as I like yours someday.